Hi guys, it's Phoebe. Welcome to my channel. I've been MIA and I promised that I wasn't gonna be MIA, but life happens, you know? So yes. How have you been? Me, I've been stressed, but I am blessed. Stressed, but blessed, because everything that is stressing me is not in my control, so I give it to the best, my Lord. But yes, anyways, hi, how are you guys? Welcome back. This video is a PCOS video, so it's going to be added to the PCOS playlist. So let's go. If you are not following me on Instagram, make sure you go follow me. My page, just like my YouTube name, it's Breaking Up With Obesity. I've had this name since like 2011. As much as I wanted to break up with obesity, I don't think that's my goal anymore, but I'm not getting rid of this name because it's my name, you know? But anyways, today's video is focusing on a question that I get asked a lot on my Instagram. I get a lot of DMs from people, and the number one question I get from women is, I've just been recently diagnosed with PCOS. What advice can you give me? And it's like I say the same thing over and over and over and over again. So I was thinking, rather than constantly giving this advice over and over again, why not make a video that will stay on YouTube for people to always go back to in case they need answers, or for new people to go to when they need answers. So I'm just gonna make this video really short because, to be quite honest, I feel like people allow the abbreviation PCOS to really bother them, and I want to make sure it does not. So here we go. So you've been recently diagnosed with PCOS. What do you do next? Here's my answer. You leave the doctor's office after your diagnosis and you move on with life. PCOS is not a death sentence. PCOS is not a terminal disease. PCOS excuse me, is not the end of the world. And that may sound cold, that may be rude, but I have PCOS, so I can say that. PCOS is not the end of the world. When you get diagnosed with PCOS, that is an opportunity to start fresh. That is an opportunity for you to take charge of your health. That's an opportunity for you to heal your body from the inside out. And I promise you, in healing your body and treating your PCOS, you are going to learn about yourself so much. So when you get diagnosed with PCOS, do not let this four-letter word break you. Do not allow it to break you, because let me tell you this, PCOS does not have you. You have PCOS. When you get diagnosed with PCOS, the next thing to do is to figure out on how to treat your PCOS, how to live with PCOS, how to move on with PCOS. PCOS is not going to take captive of your life. You are going to take PCOS by the reins and you are going to control it. Okay? It's not going to control you. You are going to control it and you are going to live your best life. When I got diagnosed with PCOS, I was 15. I got diagnosed back when there was barely any research being done for women who had PCOS. So when I got diagnosed, it was just a diagnosis. I had no clue on what to do. Excuse the noise, someone's taking a shower upstairs. I had no clue. So we literally left the doctor's office and I went back to living life, and I went back to gaining weight, and I went back to eating unhealthy, and that was it. Then when I got older, they put me on medications to treat my PCOS, and it did. And it took me years, but I finally realized that to treat PCOS, it's not something that your doctor does for you. It's something that you do for yourself. You have to take ownership of this hormone imbalance. I don't want to say disease because I hate that word, because that's what they told me. They told me I had a polycystic ovarian disease. When you get diagnosed with PCOS, this is your opportunity to take charge of your health. It's the opportunity to literally change every aspect of your life in order to make yourself better. So do not allow PCOS to break you, to reduce you, to scare you. to put a halt on your life, because I promise you, PCOS has done nothing to me. PCOS, me having PCOS has made me a better woman than I am today than I would have been without it. A lot of people say, oh my God, I hate PCOS, I wish I didn't have it. I don't say that, because PCOS is the reason I am who I am today. And as much as I hate some of my symptoms, I really don't care. So let's get back to the topic. So you've been diagnosed with PCOS, what do you do next? You change your lifestyle. And a lot of people, when they hear the word change, they get scared. Change is nothing to be afraid of. Change is a good thing. You are allowed to change as many times as you want to. A lot of people like being in control of change. When you have PCOS, you technically are still in control of this change. It's just that this change is not to make your bank account fatter. It's not to make your hair longer. It's not to make your skin brighter. Actually, it technically does make your hair longer and make your skin brighter, because when you manage your PCOS, everything changes. You see this beat? My skin used to be nasty. That's a story for another day. But you are allowed to change as many times as you want. So when you get the opportunity to change, go with it. When you're diagnosed with PCOS, look at your lifestyle. Look at things in your life that you probably never noticed before and make changes there. How is your eating? Are you hopping from diet to diet to diet to diet? Are you eating processed foods? Are you eating a lot of sugar? Are you drinking a lot of soda? Are you cooking your own food, or do you eat out often? Looking in these areas of your life, you're going to figure out exactly what changes you need to make in order to treat your PCOS. Look at your stress levels. Are you managing your stress? Are you stressed? Do you know what stress looks like? Do you know when you're stressed? Paying attention to the stressors in your life and resolving everything that is stressing you is another thing that you can do to treat your PCOS. Because when you're stressed, stress leads to high cortisol levels. And when your cortisol levels are high, honey, it equals weight gain. For some people, it equals weight loss, but for women with PCOS, most of us, it equals weight gain. And guess where we put on weight? Around the belly. Nobody wants a bigger belly. So manage your stress. Look at your sleeping. Are you sleeping enough? Are you sleeping at all? Like, do you like sleep? Because me, I like sleep. 10 o'clock, my body starts shutting down. Like, my body's like, oh, Phoebs, it's 10:05. Why aren't you in bed yet? It's time to go night-night. Like, I don't play with my sleep. I don't. Your water intake. I heard some people say they don't like water because it has no taste. I don't know about y'all, but I like my water. If you don't like water, add a little flavoring to it. A lime, a lemon, something. But get your water intake in. You should be drinking half of your body weight to a gallon of water a day. What else? Sugar intake. Cut it. A lot of people are like, limit your sugar. No, just cut that shit. Cut it out. Cut the sugar out. No. Sugar is not good for us. Just cut it. Literally cut the sugar. Because when you have sugar and you have PCOS, the little sugar that you have is going to make you crave more and more and more and more. And the more you crave it, the more you give into it, and the more you're just going backwards. So cut it. What sugar do I use when I'm cooking? The sugars I use, I use stevia, I use monk fruit, I use erythritol, melitol, I think it's called. I can't pronounce this shit. I avoid sucralose. Look, y'all better not get on me for this pronunciation. Judge your mother. And I avoid aspartame. Now, the reason I do this is because I like my diet sodas, and they got aspartame in it. But I really don't care. Judge your mother. I'm going to still drink my Diet Coke because it's better than drinking regular Coke. And that's about it. You don't have to follow a certain diet. You don't have to follow a trend. You don't have to do the whole 30. You don't have to do paleo. You don't have to do keto. You don't have to do the Atkins diet. All that shit is not necessary. When you can sit down and look at your life and see how you are living and see the areas that you think are okay and fix it so that they're better than okay, that's how you start treating your PCOS. I gave up medications years ago because I wanted to take charge of my health. Medications don't treat how you live your everyday life. And if you are not treating your PCOS from the inside out, you are not treating it at all. Medications are not treating the PCOS. They're literally just covering those symptoms. And my entire goal is to treat my PCOS and the symptoms together. I don't want to treat one and then the other one is going crazy. I'm treating everything together. So, you just recently got diagnosed with PCOS. What do you do next? You move on. PCOS is not a death sentence. It's not terminal. It's not the end of the world. And as hard as that may sound, I have PCOS, so I can tell you that. It's not the end of the world. Move on with your life. When you leave that doctor's office after you've been told you have PCOS, start right there. Even if it's like 5 o'clock in the afternoon, start right there. Start making those changes right there. Do not allow those words to dig into your heart, to dig into your mind. Do not allow PCOS to take root in your mind. Do not allow it to hurt you. Do not allow it to break you. When you are diagnosed with PCOS, it's an opportunity to start fresh. Who doesn't like a fresh start? It's like cutting your hair, you know? So when you get that diagnosis, be willing to start over. Allow yourself to start over. Allow yourself to change, because change is great. As much as we want to say change is hard, change is difficult, change is great. So when you get that diagnosis, smile and tell yourself it's time to change. And you are changing for the better. Every time you change, make sure it's for the better. Make sure it's to make yourself better, to make your family better. PCOS is not bad. PCOS sucks, but that's all that it does. It sucks. PCOS will never have you. As long as you take charge of your PCOS, you are way ahead. You don't have to listen to your doctor. You don't have to put yourself on medications. If you believe strongly that you can treat your PCOS naturally, you can be consistent enough in your changes that you can treat your PCOS naturally, then do it. No one knows you like you. Take charge of your health. If your doctor does not agree, go get another doctor. I've had 5 doctors in the past. Since I was diagnosed, I've had 7 doctors, actually. And that's okay. Because at the end of the day, no one knows you like you. And my doctor still asks me why I say no to medications. It's because I know I can treat my PCOS. And I'm doing it. So I hope this video helps you guys. Do not allow your diagnosis to really hurt you. It's not painful. It is, I don't know, it's like a doorway. It's an opportunity. It's a doorway to newer and better things. So allow yourself to receive the diagnosis. Allow yourself to feel, it hurts temporarily. The pain is not something we can avoid. Take the pain and move forward with it. Allow yourself to be disappointed, but do not stay in your disappointment. Do not sulk. Do not worry. Do not stress. When you are disappointed, take the disappointment and then take charge so you go from being disappointed to being in charge to living. I'm living my best life with my PCOS diagnosis, and I'm fine with that. Anyways, I hope you guys find this video encouraging, motivating, inspiring. If you have any questions, you can leave it in the comment box below. You can find me on Instagram at Breaking Up with Obesity. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. That's all. I absolutely love talking to you all. PCOS is something that I absolutely love talking about because it's one of the things that I know enough about because I've lived through it and I'm still living through it, you know? So anyways, today is Sunday. I wish you all a terrific week. I wish you all consistency in your eating, consistency in your workouts, consistency in just being stress-free, happy, and at peace. So, bye.